Ahoy there! We are the King Serpent Pirate Crew, and you are watching Sal's show! And here we are today to perform our Sailing Circus show! And to start off with, here's Minstrel Michael singing Sir William Gower! Let's enjoy the video!
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Sal's show. I am Minstrel Michael with the King Serpent Crew, and I'm here to entertain you with a song about a brave sea captain who comes to a bad end. I am a sailor, both stout and strong, to a goodly vessel I knew belong. Both in his bed did lay, when a dreadful voice to him did say, "This night with me in the deep you'll be, so prepare yourselves and your company." The sky grew dark and the sea grew still, old men were fearful and the air was chill. Sir William rose men, saying, "Hear me now, for I'll not speak again. I killed a man that I held dear, all for the sake of his lady fair. For I was moved by cruel jealousy, so I now must face that which comes to me. A timber close to my side and throw me out on the waters wide. And if I swim, then let me be, and if I sink, then pray for me." So he tied his head and we tied his feet, and around his middle a winding sheet. At every knot the sea did stir, ready for a murderer. And then we saw his open grave in the likeness of a single wave that swept our ship from her stern to her bow and bore away Sir William Gower.
The King Serpent Pirate Crew, and you are watching Sal's show. Up next, I'm going to give you the story of the tragedy that happened between me and my first mate, Oscar Andrews. Let's enjoy the video.
And now it is my utmost pleasure to present to you the captain to whom I hold my liege, the fiercest pirate on the seven seas today and certain parts of Malden, Captain David Forktongue!
Hey! Good to see you!
And you, Captain, you're looking swell!
And you as well! Well, it's good to be here on Sal's show! So, it's great to be back! Let me introduce myself for those of you who didn't know me from the past! My name is David Forktongue, and I am a very well-known pirate captain! Now today on Sal's show, we're going to share some stories of piracy. Minstrel Michael will entertain you with some wonderful sea ditties. And also our good and lovely mate, Lady Josephine, is here as well. She'll be joining us a little bit later. But first, let me tell you a little bit about myself. My name is David Forktongue, and yes, I am a very well-known pirate captain. Now, I didn't always start off that way. I started off my career as a member of a crew aboard a military vessel. And I served the captain of that ship, a man by the name of Captain William Warren, very, very faithfully. Well, as faithfully as you can get, because from his perspective, I didn't serve him too faithfully. And I will admit, Mr. Michael, it probably didn't help any that a member of the crew caught myself and the good captain's wife in some very interesting positions, if you know what I mean. Ah, yes, and let me tell you, the captain's wife was living proof the treasure is not all gold and silver, if you know what I'm talking about. But yes, I was caught with the good captain's wife, and it was given orders that I was to be executed by hanging on the morrow. Aye, so they shackled me up, took me and locked me in the brig. Now the morrow came, and where was I? I was nowhere to be found. Well, even though I like to share some of the adventures of piracy, that is one story I keep close to my heart. It is my secret, and it's a secret I will not reveal. But what I will reveal is that years later, I was seen captaining my own ship and sailing that ship under a flag of piracy, mates! And I made quite a name for myself, accumulated many members in my crew, including Minstrel Michael and Lady Josephine as well. And I accumulated much treasure. Now, treasure is not all gold and silver, if you know what I'm talking about. Yes, treasure comes in the form of females as well when you're a pirate, am I right? But also, my treasure is also knowledge of other pirates. Now, we're going to share some adventures of piracy. Let me start off with a little adventure of me own. Now, the first lesson that you always learn in piracy is that you often will keep one eye in front and the other eye watching over your shoulder. I learned that lesson the hard way with my first mate, a man by the name of Oscar Andrews. Now, Oscar Andrews, once upon a time, was a pirate captain himself. And one day, he was stuck in a military vessel. His plan was to take that vessel and turn it into his flagship. Now, at the same time he was attacking, there was another ship attacking in the other direction. And who was the captain of that ship but me? And we both attacked the ship at the same time. But then we got a little bit confused and thought, you know what? This has never happened before. But it's always good to share to get tasks done. So we agreed to share and attack and pillage the other ship. Makes sense, right? Well, we did just that. And we took over the ship and made it our flagship. And we were victorious and a huge celebration broke out right there on the deck of the ship. But unfortunately, mates, the celebration was short-lived. For you see, both Oscar Andrews and myself both decided we wanted to be the captains of the ship. Nice touch. Well, so, suffice it to say, the battle then turned to each other. And we fought back and forth, and I beat him right there on the deck of the ship. And I was named the new captain. Aye, but old Oscar Andrews oftentimes will try to retake the captain's position quite unsuccessfully, I might add. Except for one time, he conducted a mutiny against me. And all the members of the crew took me, shackled me up, and placed me in the brig. And then they called for the lifeboat. And they took me out, placed me in that lifeboat with no supplies, provision, food, or water, not even any rum or grog. And they sent me adrift in the ocean. Now the plan was that they hoped that the sun, the sea, and whatever's swimming around in the water will be just enough to do me in the end. Aye. Now, there's a port known as Porta Gotor, which is a somewhat safe haven for pirates. Now, Captain Andrews, as he commissioned himself quite inappropriately, set a course for Porta Gotor. Now, Porta Gotor was set up by another well-known pirate captain by the name of Gentleman Jason Williams. Gentleman Jason was now retired, and he set up Porto Gojo to be a safe haven for us pirates. So there is Captain Andrews and crew celebrating the night away at Williams Tavern Inn. When who should arrive in port unexpectedly but me? And all the music stopped, and our focused gaze on Oscar Andrews, and I approached him and I said, "So, you thought you could leave me tied in that lifeboat and leave me to sail onward to the Dutchman?" And he dropped to his knees and begged to be spared. And I looked him right in the eyes, and he back at me. And I drew me pistol, and I said, "I didn't think you had it in you!" And with that, I joined in the celebration and retook the captain's position. And we all had a grand evening. Well, not everyone. Oscar Andrews was not too happy. But I agreed to demote him back down to first mate. Now, a lot of people question me on why I did that. There's another rule of piracy. This is a rule of life, too, in some ways. The rule is that you always keep your friends close and your enemies closer, mates. Well, as I promised, we're going to have a little bit of musical entertainment as well. Minstrel Michael, let's say we introduce them to and teach them all here on Sal's Show. Let me remind you, you are watching Sal's Show, and to learn more about the King Serpent crew, go to kingserpent.com.
If you want to be a pirate, one of the first things you have to do is learn the tools of the trade, and the big tool of the pirate's trade is the sailing ship. Here's a song that teaches you all you need to know about sailing one of the big clipper ships. Let's enjoy the video!
What say we entertain these folks and educate them with the sailor's alphabet?
What a good idea!
All right!
Because if you're going to be a pirate, obviously the first thing you need to learn is how to manage the ship.
Ah, that's true.
And here is a story, a song, where we've taken some of the important parts of a sailing vessel and set them in rhyme.
A is for the anchor that rides at our bow. B is for the bowsprit and the tips on my low. C is for the capstan that we all run around. And D is for the davits that lower the boats down. A sailor at sea, heave away, haul away, ship rolls along. Give a sailor his grog and there's nothing goes wrong.
E's for the ensign that at our mast flew. F is for the forecastle where lives our crew. G is for the galley where the salt junk smells strong. H for the halyards we hoist with a song.
Merrily, merrily, so merrily sail we. No mortal on earth like a sailor at sea. Heave away, haul away, the ship rolls along. Give a sailor his grog and there's nothing goes wrong.
They're good for the feet. J is for the chins that hang by the lee sheet. K is for the knight's bridge where the petty officer stands. And L is for the lee side hard found by new hands.
Merrily, merrily, so merrily sail we. No mortal on earth like a sailor at sea.
Give a sailor his grog and there's nothing goes wrong.
M's for the mainmast, it's stout and it's strong. N is for the needle that never points wrong. O is for the oar of our old jolly boats. And P for the pinnace that lively do float.
Merrily, merrily, so merrily sail we. No mortal on earth like the sailor at sea. Heave-way, haul-way, ship rolls along. Give a sailor his grog and then nothing goes wrong.
Q's for the quarterdeck where the officers stand. R's for the rudder keeps the ship in command. S is for the stunsails that drive us along. And T is for the topsail to get there takes long. Cause it's so far up there, you know.
Aye! Merrily, merrily, so merrily sail we. No mortal on earth like a sailor at sea. Heave away, haul away, the ship rolls along. Give a sailor his grog and there's nothing goes wrong.
U is for the uniform, mostly worn aft. For the pants that hangs by the main gast. W's the water that's on a pint and a pound. And X marks the spot where old Stormy was drowned.
Oh, wait, wait, moment of silence.
Oh, poor Stormy!
I miss that old dude.
We miss him! Oh,
merrily, merrily, so merrily sail we.
Except for Stormy.
No mortal
true. And that proves we're mortal.
Exactly.
Heave-way, haul-away, the ship rolls along. Give a sailor his grog and there's nothing goes wrong.
Y is for the yardarm, keeps the ship in command. For Zoe, I'm her fancy man.
Where is she?
Later.
Oh, okay.
She's also for Zero in the cold winter time. And now we have brought all the letters in rhyme.
Merrily, merrily, so merrily sail we. No mortal on earth like a sailor at sea. Heave away, haul away, the ship rolls along. Give a sailor his grog.
I hope you've been taking notes, because
it'll be on the exam.
Ha ha! That's right! Ahoy there, the King Serpent Pirate Crew here, and you are watching Sal's show. Now, here we are again with our Sailing Circus show, and here is Minstrel Michael singing the very wonderful song, The Coachman!
I once took a job as a coachman. The money was paid in advance. So first I booked passage to Dover, and then I crossed over to France. I worked for a very fine lady who clothed me in breeches so tight. She said, I see I have got a fine coachman to drive me by day and by night. She was such a charming young lady, all in the height of her bloom. And me being a dashing young coachman, I drove her 10 times around the room. First she took me down to the kitchen, where she plied me with liquor so quick. She bade me to drink in a hurry. Then she asked for a look at my whip. She held it and viewed it a moment, and then put it down with a smile. She said, "I see by the length and the look of your slash, you can drive in the old-fashioned style." She was such a charming young lady, all in the height of her bloom. And me, being a dashing young coachman, I drove her 10 times round the room. She bade me get into position, so I climbed right up in the seat. Three swishes I gave with me cracker, and I drove her right down the high street. I handled the whip with good judgment until I was sure of her ways. But the very first tug that I gave on the brakes, I broke the mainspring of her stays. She was such a charming young lady, all in the height of her bloom. And me, being a dashing young coachman, I drove her 10 times round the room. When me mistress grew tired or grew weary, and needed to take a short rest, she'd call for her servant maid Sally, the one whom I love second best. She said, "Sally, we've got a fine coachman. He understands driving in style. While the spring on me chassis being strengthened again, I'll let him drive you for a while." She was such a charming young lady, both of really all in the height of their bloom. And me, being a dashing young coachman, I drove her 10 times round the room. She was such a charming young lady, all in the height of her bloom. And me, being a dashing young coachman, I drove her 10 times round the room.
Ahoy there! We are the King Serpent Pirate Crew, and you are watching Sal's Show. Up next, we are going to give you the story of Anna, the handsome cabin boy. Let's enjoy the video! So let me remind you, mates, this is the King Serpent Pirate Crew, and you are watching Sal's Show. Now, this next story I want to share with you tells a story of a woman named Anna. Now, this also tells you, many people think that love is just a wonderful thing. But let me tell you, mates, love can be blind. As was the case with our friend, the lovely Anna. Now, many a sailor and pirate believe that to have a woman on board during a sea voyage, 'tis bad luck. Now, Anna knew this, but she was so desperately in love with the sea, it consumed her, and in the end, it consumed her to death. She decided she wanted to go to sea, nonetheless with all of these superstitions. To do so, she purchased a boy's sailor suit and cut her beautiful long black hair nice and short. And she managed to fool everybody by enlisting with a well-known pirate captain.
Now, Anna, or Andrew, as she went by, managed to cover up her secret quite nicely and even went on to become the ship's cabin boy. But one night, during a fierce storm, with rain and hail, thunder and lightning, pushing and splashing against the ship, there is poor young Anna, struggling to keep a tray of food afloat for the captain. She makes her way over in the storm, holding the food, a bit of beef, a nice mug of grog, and a hot bowl of soup for the captain. Now, as she's struggling in the storm to keep the tray afloat, she gets to the captain's cabin and opens the door. And a huge wave pushes against Anna, and she almost spills the entire tray of food all over the captain. But she manages to pull it back, get strength on the tray, and dumps the entire tray of food all over herself, sparing the good captain the humiliation. Now, she did just that, but the captain looks at young Anna and says, "Boy, what is the matter with you?" As her clothes start sticking to her body, the ship's doctor is then called in. And the doctor examines young Anna, and within moments, he is able to reveal the secret that she so desperately tried to hide. "Captain!" one of the men shouted. "This cabin boy is no boy. This is a woman!" And with that, the captain of the ship scored at Anna as she ran out of his cabin. And the captain gave orders, "Seize the cabin boy!" And the whole crew jumps on top of Anna, grabbing her and holding her secure. And the captain addressed them, "Men, the ship is cursed! This cabin boy is no boy, this is a woman! Send her to the Dutchman!" And they pick up the struggling body of Anna. "No! Dies right there on the spot. And the spot wasn't marked with X, let me tell you, because there was no treasure to be gained for poor young Anna. Now, many people passing by that area oftentimes refer to that area as the area known for Anna, the handsome cabin boy. It's of a pretty female, as you may understand. Her mind being bent for rambling unto a foreign land. She dressed herself in sailor's clothes, or so it would appear, and she hired with a captain to serve him for a year. Her cheeks, they were like roses, her hair done up in curls. The sailors often smiled and said, "He looks just like a girl." But one night during a fierce great storm, her secret was destroyed, and the Dutchman was the fate for her, the handsome cabin boy. Now, shortly after Anna was sent to the Dutchman, the storm suddenly broke, and the clouds cleared and the moon stars shone brightly in the sky. A warm summer breeze washed over the crew as they sailed onward peacefully. Now, the next 3 days brought good fortune to the captain and crew. They arrived at 3 different islands within 3 days. loaded with treasure of all sorts. Gold, jewels, emeralds, and riches of all sorts. As they departed the island of the third Eve, the captain made a speech and addressed the crew. Men, I'm very proud of you all. Our good fortune is due to ye all acting quickly when given orders to send our stowaway to the Dutchman. And with that, a huge celebration broke out with song, dance, food, and enough grog to last the whole evening, and the merriment would last all night long. Now, the next day, the ship sailed onward, and at the course and speed they were heading, they should have been ported by dusk. However, dusk rolled around, and nothing in the ocean looked familiar. No ships, no ports, nothing, just open sea as far as they could all see. Now they checked the maps, charts, compasses, directions of the wind. All was on course. Aye, but you see, nothing looked familiar, and they just sailed onward and onward and onward, day after day, week after week, month after month, the ship sailed. And very slowly, many of the crew started to become driven insane by the heat and the hot sun. And slowly the provisions would wear out. The food was gone, the water, even the rum. And they continued to be driven insane. And the ship would just sail onward and onward. Until one night, one of the crew looked out in the middle of the ocean and saw what looked like a little fish leaping out of the water. But as the ship got closer, they could see that not fish at all. They had what looked like mermaids. Captain, one of the men shouted, there be mermaids in these waters. Yes, mermaids. Dozens approached and surrounded the ship, looking at each member of the crew. And the crew were entranced by the incredible beauty of the little mermaids. Each one looked through each one of the crew with their sultry dance, their sweet song, and their incredible beauty. None of the crew could resist the mermaids' hypnotizing awe. Hypnotizing awe. Suddenly, the little mermaid swam away and out of the water rose the ghostly figure of a woman, pale and white, and wearing a boy sailor suit. And the ghostly figure looked with agony at each member of the crew, and one of the men shouted,
"It's her! It's the ghost of the woman we sent to the Dutchman! It's her!"
"Aye, yes," and the ghostly figure made her way down and focused her gaze on the captain. And then she quickly passed right through him, and he was thrown into a fit of rage. "No, no, no, no," cried the captain. And then suddenly the skies clouded up, and a fierce storm broke out. Thunder, lightning, rain, and hail, waves pushing and splashing against the ship. The captain is writhing in agony. "No, no, no, we are doomed," the man shouted. "Abandon ship, abandon ship." And they made their way to the lifeboats, but it was no use. The storm struck the lifeboats and ripped them to shreds, trapping the crew aboard the ship. And as the ship was being ripped apart, they could hear the sound of female laughter. "Ha ha ha ha! Doom engulfs you all! Doom! Doom! Doom!" And this ship is being ripped apart and slowly driven down to Davy Jones. Suddenly, the storm broke. The sky shone bright in the sky, and all was peaceful once again. Aye.
"We are on Sal's show with the crew of the King Serpent, and we're going to play for you the sailing song, which is also a big Irish dance hit, The Wild Rover."
But let me tell you, mates, many a ship have driven through those waters over the years. And whether you're a sailor or a pirate, a proud pirate, the rule is you gotta keep a weather eye out for mermaids, because it has been known that the mermaids will do the bidding of the ghost of Anna, the handsome cabin boy. "One night while all were lost at sea, not one known port in sight, mermaids came and approached the ship from the left and from the right. Using such charm and beauty, all were under their great spell. And all members of the ship and crew were dragged down straight to hell. So, dear friends, drink your glass of grog, and I wish you all great joy. And here's hope you have a jolly lot more than the handsome cabin boy. And, dear friends, drink your glass of grog, and I wish you all great joy. And here's hope you have a jolly lot more than the handsome cabin boy." Aye, and you are watching Sal's show. And once again, ladies and gentlemen, here on Sal's show, the King Serpent Pirate Crew presents the very lovely Lady Josephine! Thank you. Serpent Pirate Crew, and you are watching Sal's Show. Now, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. As well as me and Minstrel Michael here, we have another member of the crew here. She is lovely to look at, but she can be deadly with a sword. The very beautiful Lady Josephine! Ha ha!
Thank you. subpoenaed the crew of the King Serpent. Visit our website at www.kingserpent.com. You're watching Sal's Show. Sal's Show is your show. If you'd like to be on Sal's Show, contact us at this address.
It's been great being here on Sal's Show. So we want to leave you with another fine song that definitely tells a definite story. This song is called Wild Rover. Now, many of you may be familiar with this song, but this is a much different version, a truer version in our opinion, because you see, in this version, the Wild Rover is not, it is not a dance. It is a pirate ship. And this tragically tells of a young lad who served as a member of the crew of the Wild Rover, but then decided to repent for his crimes of piracy. Will he sail the Wild Rover? No, never, no more. I've sailed the Wild Rover for many a year, and I left all the doubloons for rum and for beer. But now I'm returning with gold and great soul, and I never will sail the Wild Rover no more, and it's no day. Confess what I've done, and I ask them to pardon their buccaneer son. And as they caress me as often before, well, I never will sail the Wild Rover no more. And it's no day, never, no day, never, no more will I sail the Wild Rover, no, never.
Christmas in the Trenches, written by John McCutcheon.
Oh, my name is Francis Tolliver, I come from Liverpool. 2 years ago, the war was waiting for me after school. From Belgium into Flanders, from Germany to here, I fought for king and country I hold dear. 'Twas Christmas in the trenches, where the frost so bitter hung. The frozen fields of France were still, no Christmas songs were sung. Our families back in England drank a toast to us that day, their brave and glorious lads so far away. Lying with my messmates on the cold and rocky ground, when across the line of battle came a most peculiar sound. Says I, now listen up, me boys, each soldier strained to hear, as one lone German voice rang out so clear. He's singing bloody well, you know, me partner says to me. Soon one by one each German voice joined in harmony. The cannons rested silent, the gas clouds rolled no more, as Christmas brought us respite from the war. Gentlemen struck up some lads from Kent. The next they sang was Stille Nacht, 'tis silent night, says I, and in two tongues one song filled up the sky. There's someone coming towards us, the front rank sentry cried. All eyes were fixed on one lone figure coming from their side. His truce flag like a Christmas star shone in the air so bright, as he boldly stepped unarmed into the night. Soon one by one from either side climbed into no man's land. With neither gun nor bayonet we met there hand to hand. We shared some secret brandy and we wished each other well, and in a flare-lit soccer game we gave him hell. We traded chocolate cigarettes and photographs from home, these sons and fathers far away from families of their own. Alexander's played his squeeze box and they had a violin, this curious and unlikely band of men. Soon daylight stole upon us, and France was France once more. With sad farewells we all began to settle back to war. But the question haunted every heart that lived that wondrous night, whose family have I fixed within my sight? 'Twas Christmas in the trenches where the frost so bitter hung. The frozen fields of France were warmed as Christmas songs were sung. Walls they'd built between us to enact the work of war had been crumbled and were gone forevermore. So my name is Francis Tolliver, in Liverpool I dwell. Each Christmas comes since World War I, I've learned its lessons well. That the ones who call the shots won't be among the dead and lame, and on each end of the rifle, we're the same.
Well, that's all the time we have here on Sal's show. We have been Captain David Forktongue.
Hi! And the crew of the King Serpent Pirate Crew. Now remember, Sal's show is your show, and if you want to be a performer, just check out the website, the email address below, and it's been great. We'll see you next time on Sal's show.
Ahoy, everyone.
Bye.